LaCrosse. He's the executive chef by Basil's by the Lake. His sous chef Jose joining us as well as we are answering the question, what's for dinner? Today we are making fish, dear.
We're not.
No. This is much better. So, Scott, you're doing a wonderful salmon. Salmon's so good right now.
It is. We're starting off with the salmon. We have it in a pan with just a little bit of olive oil, sea salt, and fresh parsley.
Okay. Is that on a low or a high heat over there?
High heat, yeah. The mushrooms over here went into a dry pan. I'm adding a little bit of butter to them right now, some fresh garlic and shallots, and we're going to season those up. Once they release all of their water, then we're going to deglaze with a little bit of white wine. So just add white wine in there so it takes the flavor back inside.
And you were just telling me that mushrooms are 90% water?
Just about 90% water. So to get the flavor inside, you need to draw all the water out and then put the flavor back in. So as we're doing the mushrooms, it takes a little bit longer. We started with the salmon, get a nice caramelization here on the salmon. And then we're going to drop a little bit of olive oil into our saute pan over here for our spinach. So just right into a warm pan. We are going to put a little shallot in there. And Chris is going to help me out with the spinach. Can we just pop it in the pan?
Pop it right in the pan.
You bet.
Okay.
And all we're going to do with that is just season up a little bit of salt. And we're just wilting it just a touch. And then we're going to go right to the plate with it.
You know, we've been talking about going green this week. And especially in California, for doing this kind of a dish, you can get all of this local.
You can get all of it local. The fish is local. The mushrooms from a local produce company, General Produce. Spinach, good fresh spinach. That's what we do.
This year it's good.
This year it's good.
We weren't so fond of it last year, but this year we're okay with it.
Absolutely.
How long does it typically take to wilt spinach?
That's just about it.
Really?
I would take it out right now. If you cook it any longer, it's just going to wilt down really down to nothing, and
okay.
We don't want that at all. So we're going to take it like this while it's still cooking. We're just going to go in to our plate here. Our salmon's just about finished as well. Take the salmon there. And our mushrooms, just here. Finish those up with a little bit of white wine.
Now, why are you doing that? Is that just to give it a little more flavor?
Well, because we dried the mushroom all the way up, mm-hmm. Now we need to put some flavor inside. It's going to absorb it back in, and the flavor is going to go all throughout the mushroom.
The heat burns the alcohol part of it off, right?
You bet the heat does. Yeah, all that's left is the good apple flavor of the Chardonnay that I'm using.
Yeah, it looks great.
And then we just go right
to
it.
Smells wonderful as well.
Right to the plate here. A little lemon garnish on there. That's the dish.
And that's it. How long would you say, if somebody wanted to try this for dinner this week, how long would you say to do it at home yourself?
It takes no more than 20 minutes.
Okay.
A fillet of fish, the salmon, the mushrooms, quick and easy, ready to go. No special ingredients needed, just good food.
And heart healthy as well. Scott, we appreciate it. Thanks for joining us today.
All right, thank you.
Great recipe. All right.